Did you know America's high school graduation rate ranks 19th in the world? 40 years ago, we were number one. Our region has some of the highest dropout rates in the state of Pennsylvania. So what's being done to change that? We'll show you programs in place, attempting to keep kids in school, and we'll have the warning signs every parent should know to help prevent their child from becoming another statistic. Right now, on Tempo In Depth.
Support for Tempo In-Depth is provided by the members of PBS 39 and by
building a workforce system called PA Career Link Lehigh Valley, training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs, connecting employers with workers, and workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. Over the course of a 30-minute program like this one, nearly 70 students will drop out of high school. Statistics show that's one every 26 seconds. It's an alarming number that impacts all of us. Dropouts make up nearly half the heads of households on welfare. A high school dropout will earn $200,000 less over their lifetimes than high school graduates, and $800,000 less than college graduates. Here's another alarming statistic: 65% of convicts are dropouts. Crystal Fisher introduces us to three of those statistics and looks at how some local schools are trying to keep kids engaged.
When you were younger, did you ever try a cigarette to look cool or cut class just to hang out? How far would you go to fit in?
I wanted to be with the in crowd, you know, so I got caught up and wanted to be in the streets opposed to me pursuing my goals.
I was an honor roll student, and summertime came and met a new crowd.
Well, my senior year, I'll be honest, I fell into the wrong crowd. You know, started using drugs, mostly marijuana and cocaine.
The in crowd cost Donald Heinbecker Jr., Rashid Barton, and Miguel Rios their high school diploma and much more.
It wasn't really that I dropped out. It was kind of like I ended up, you know, leaving with my friends, you know, with lunch and just leaving school halfway early and not coming back.
Before he knew it, he'd missed too many classes to graduate.
I had the gown, I had the cap, I had the tassel, you know, but I never got to use it.
You might be thinking, that couldn't be my boy. He plays football and makes honor roll. Well, so did Donald.
I didn't, you know, use around my family, you know. They didn't know I was still using, you know. They thought I was on the right path, you know, I would use elsewhere, so they really didn't have no idea. You know, until 1 o'clock in the morning when the cops were at the door.
Stealing from jobs to keep up with his habits landed him in Northampton County Prison. According to the Pennsylvania Workforce Investment Board, 80% of inmates never made it through high school.
I never even went to high school. My last grade I actually completed was eighth grade.
The Pennsylvania Department of Education reported that in the 2006-2007 school year, more than 14,400 students dropped out of grades 7 through 12.
The latest report shows that overall the dropout rate in Pennsylvania is 1.6%, which doesn't sound too high. But when you narrow that down to grades 9 through 12, check out the rates in some urban areas. In Allentown, William Allen had an 8.1% dropout rate, which means 300 students didn't make it to graduation. At Reading High School, 7.5% dropped out. Germantown in Philadelphia lost 9.5% of their teens. Compare those numbers to suburban schools and they're much lower. In Bucks County, for example, Council Rock South had a 0.1% dropout rate, or 3 students. Central Bucks East had a 0.5% rate. Parkland High School had 0.7%, but they all fell under 1%. So what's happening? Over the past 3 years as Director of Student Services in Reading, Dr. Rose Morell James has worked closely with the schools, developing programs to combat dropout rates.
What we have done on our end is put people out in the field, as well as combining our efforts in the school to be able to have people go. Some of our homeschool visitors or our intervention counselors or our mental health team go and knock on the door and ask parents and ask students, where are you? We need you in school.
She says the main reason students drop out is a lack of connection. They feel like no one cares. So with the help of home and school visitors like Jose Boraz, Reading officials aim to reconnect with their kids.
I'm a person that is coming here to help you identify what are the problems and provide you with options.
Jose says sometimes it's as simple as not having a jacket in the winter or no parents to walk you to school. But often it's a lack of confidence.
They're experiencing a hard time in understanding a subject matter, so they feel embarrassed.
Typically, it begins with problems with the academics, usually reading. The lack of literacy skills for these students is overwhelmingly the number one reason that leads to other issues.
At William Allen in Allentown, Keith Snyder teaches with the Read 180 program, designed to reignite a passion with reading and learning.
The reading becomes so laborious and so frustrating that they don't do the work. The hope is that as they learn these different skills and strategies in this class, that they can take those to their textbooks in their science and their social studies to help make better sense of what they're reading.
Ideally, rekindling a passion for reading and keeping them in school.
We are slowly making gains. I would say that we are successful in all of our programs. The problem is we need more. It's unfortunate, but we need to provide more support for more students each year.
There are some students that are just troubled. They're just troubled, but we have to provide the options and the opportunities.
Options that begin with a high school diploma.
Make the right choices right now, you know, because if you don't, you could get caught up in that trap.
Rashid recently finished his GED testing and hopes to become a welder.
The things I thought were important were not, you know. The people I thought were important were not. You'll have time for friends after school, after you do high school, after you do college.
Donald says once he's completed the prison's diploma program, he wants to trade in this jumper for an Army uniform. From now on, he wants to fit in with the right crowd. For Tempo In Depth, I'm Crystal Fisher reporting.
Fitting in with the right crowd is so very important. Our next guest joins me now. Michael Shook is now almost 19 years old. Michael, we appreciate your time and your willingness to share your story, which is pretty interesting. You repeated your freshman year twice. Admittedly, you got wrapped up in the wrong crowd, made some bad choices, started drinking alcohol and using drugs, and you spent 10 months in the Lehigh County prison. But now you're back on track. You're in school at Freedom High School, working your senior year, and you can almost taste that diploma. Help us understand what sent you to prison and what kind of turned your life around to get you back on the right track.
When I was 16 years old, I was drinking and using drugs and, you know, just caught up in my own self-centeredness, you know, just doing what I want to do. And I got in trouble and got charged with aggravated assault, robbery, and reckless endangerment. You know, just trying to get more money from somebody. And I was in Lehigh County Prison for 10 months, you know, and I was in there. There was a diploma program, and Allentown School District, like a teacher came out into the prison and had a classroom set up. Like, it wasn't a classroom, but it was like a activity room.
How were your grades in that?
In there?
Mm-hmm.
I had all A's and B's. I started getting all A's and B's in there.
And that's not what you had when you were in regular high school.
Oh, no, I was failing everything. And
what do you think the change was?
Oh, just every time I was in an institution, I always did well. So just at that point in time, it was just because I didn't have nothing else better to do, and I had all my time to do schoolwork.
No distractions.
Correct.
So you got out of prison, and you're back in a traditional high school, right?
Yes.
You were sharing with me, what recommendations do you have for other kids who might be on that verge and think, you know what, I'm a teenager, I need to make my own decisions, I want to have fun, I want to do my own thing. What advice do you have for them?
I wouldn't recommend do your own thing, you know. Usually in my mind, every time I wanted to do something myself, I usually got myself into trouble. And I just recommend staying into some kind of programs at school if it has to be anything, like band, athletics, you know, like even helping out another person.
Clubs,
anything, you know, just to even tutor little kids, you know. You can volunteer at elementary schools, you know, to help out somebody else, you know, and be able to, like, satisfy somebody else's needs, you know, usually helps me understand where I came from and what I didn't get. And usually then, I'm not going to say that they're going to stay out of all troubles, you know, because there's still other parts they have to do. But at least stay in some clubs and activities in school and, like, not always hang out with people, you know. Spend quality time with yourselves and get to know yourself.
So it's that sense of belonging that you missed, you lacked out in high school, that you think can help others maybe stay in, staying connected to people.
Yes.
What are your plans for the future? You can almost taste that diploma now. You're almost there. What's the next step?
Going to Northampton Community College for Culinary Arts. It's a two-year program that starts out in August. And after there, my goals and my plans are to transfer over to Pittsburgh University and go into their culinary program then.
So it sounds like you've got this really good plan that others can learn from your mistakes so that they don't make the same mistakes. But what do you think is standing between you and that degree from Pittsburgh now?
Like, you know, where I came from thinking I'm a failure, you know, I still think sometimes like I'm not going to make it, you know, but like I say, God didn't bring me this far to drop me off, you know, and that's where I see it. You know, if I put my mind to it, you know, and you put what you can do in life, you know, you usually can go for it.
You mentioned you were involved in a 12-step program too that kind of helped you get off some of the addictions that you had.
Yes.
So that's a big part in the recovery process and helping you see that you have a plan for the future.
Yes, there's a lot of people in the program who like even wants to help me out, you know, like when I was incarcerated, there was a fella in there who like helped me, like when I didn't want to do nothing, like he pushed me, you know, and I gotta say, like 2 years later, you know, like me and him are outside and, you know, he's still pushing me to help me out to succeed in life.
Well, Michael Shook, we are pulling for you. You know you can do it when you put your mind to it, and we wish you nothing but success. Thank you for sharing your story with others. We hope it will encourage other people.
Thank you.
What if you could look at a child and know right away that they're at risk for dropping out? Longtime teachers will tell you it's something they can just pick up on, but school officials don't have to rely on gut feelings anymore. Now they systematically assess which students could eventually leave school based on a whole list of factors. Tempo In Depth's Laura McHugh explains how schools hope taking a closer look at kids early on will help them secure their diplomas.
Imagine if every day of school brought a struggle. A string of bad grades breeds a bad attitude. The student starts missing class more often, and by high school, quits coming altogether.
It's really troubling. It's actually pretty devastating.
Every year, this pattern results in 1.2 million students dropping out of high school. That's one student every 26 seconds.
We've invested as a community, as a school district, a lot, emotion, dollars and cents into this child, and we want them to be a productive member of society. We understand that an appropriate education is a necessity in order for that to take place. So it is. It is very emotional when you see kids walk through these doors and try to struggle through.
At Easton Area High School, 87% of freshmen graduate. While that rate exceeds state standards, it still means 65 to 70 students don't get that diploma. As an eighth grader, 14-year-old Colton Clark showed signs he might be one of them. He admits that school wasn't a priority, that he got bad grades and was regularly suspended.
I didn't want to do any more work. I just wanted to come here, get out of school, and just join the military for my life.
Hey Colton, how you doing?
For the first time in 2008, officials at the high school asked teachers and administrators at their feeder schools to identify kids like Colton who were at risk for eventually dropping out. They considered factors including poor academic achievement, low attendance rates, retention or failure to get promoted to the next grade level, disengagement, and behavior problems. District officials say it's critical to address students with these risk factors at ninth grade right as they're entering high school, because without intervention, about 11 to 12% of freshmen won't get promoted to 10th grade.
Last year, we had 11.7% of our ninth graders retained in ninth grade. That means they did not move on with their class to 10th grade. And it's a really significant number and much too high of a number.
Using the risk factors, they identified 47 students and created a new program called Skills for Success. Three times a week for one class period, the students work one-on-one with volunteer tutors from Lafayette College.
I'm glad. I'm really happy I'm in that class because my grades are all A's and B's now. And my honor roll average is a 90, and I hope I keep it that way every year.
I was like, why am I in this? I must be dumb or something. So, but then as it started going more and more, I started liking it better with the tutors helping me and everything, so.
The typical student doesn't have an opportunity to have a small group instruction or a tutor available to them on a daily or every other day basis. And that's what this program provides.
Other risk factors include socioeconomic status, transiency, disability, abuse or neglect, and ethnicity. Data shows students who are Hispanic, African American, come from a low-income family, or have a disability are all more likely to drop out of school. Based on all these factors, many studies show that students at risk for dropping out can be identified as early as sixth grade, and in many cases, even earlier.
We've actually had children come in not knowing any letters, not knowing any sound shapes, et cetera. They're behind the other children, so that's why we have to identify them and try to get them the things that they need so that they can be successful.
According to Shoemaker, third grade is a pivotal year.
Keep your hand up if you've got more than 30.
Once it keeps dropping, it'll keep on getting taller, but it won't get wider.
And number ones, you're going to count the drops for them.
He says studies show that if a student can't read on grade level at third grade, their risk for dropping out increases 30 to 40%.
It kind of makes sense because as children are getting older, as they're progressing through the grade levels and they fall farther and farther behind, many times it becomes a situation where the child feels overwhelmed and like there's no end in sight, like they're not going to be successful.
A program called RTI, short for Response to Intervention, has teachers assess students several times a year starting in kindergarten. As soon as they notice a student falling behind, they send them for extra instruction with a specialist like Kristen Price.
So we're not waiting for them to fail, we're being very proactive about it. And therefore the children are feeling much better about themselves. What did you do over your break? Huh? All right. Yeah, well it shows. Good job.
At the beginning of the school year, Kristen began working with fourth grade students Trevor, Eduardo, and Bobby. At that time, they read 40 to 50 words a minute. Halfway through the school year, they've all doubled their reading rates.
We're seeing sometimes a whole year or more growth in a child that we weren't seeing before. You know, let's say a second grader coming in on a first grade level, you know, a whole year behind, is able to catch up to almost meeting second grade benchmark. Maybe not quite, but you know, that's a huge amount of growth that we were never seeing before we had these research-based programs.
Now in its fourth year, district officials count the RTI program as a success. Back at the high school, it's still too soon to know how Skills for Success will affect student retention, but they already see students responding.
When I get like bad grades and things, I start saying that I don't like school and things like that. But then when I get good grades, I start saying, just okay, this maybe I'll be able to do this.
By spending more time looking for the warning signs and treating the ones they find early on, officials hope to change more than students' attitudes. They hope to change a student's life. For Tempo In Depth, I'm Laura McHugh reporting.
3 years ago, some concerned educators in Bethlehem got together to determine how they might save struggling students from dropping out of high school. They came up with the idea of Career Academy. Here, kids with non-traditional learning styles get the attention they need in small class settings. They go to their own separate school where teachers give them the personalized attention they need. Instead of falling off the track, Career Academy students get on track to graduation, jobs, and even college. Tempo In Depth's Grover Silcox tells us more.
These students discovered the key to learning at Bethlehem's Career Academy. They found their confidence.
The school changed my whole life around. The school, it's like, it's not even a school, it's just like home. It's like, this is family. And like, the teachers that are here care about you so much, and they try to help you out so much.
This is very family-oriented school. Like, there's nothing better than these teachers right here.
May I have your attention, please?
The Bethlehem Area School District's Career Academy opened 3 years ago at the urging of parents, teachers, and administrators to help kids who were struggling in the traditional school setting and even thinking of dropping out.
Oh yeah, I've thought about it, you know, and then thought about all the consequences.
My mom, she has a real bad illness, and I always felt I had to stay home to take care of her and instead of coming to school.
They gave up on school because they thought school had given up on them.
They show a big change in behavior and attitude towards school. A lot of them are excited about coming. They feel at home when they're here.
What does an experiment produce?
The Career Academy enables students the opportunity to get all their academic credits while either taking classes at the Bethlehem area VOTEC or working at a paying job where the school monitors their progress.
This year especially, we have half our students that are vocational VOTEC students and another half that are work experience.
Most of the kids come to Career Academy from Freedom and Liberty, Bethlehem's two traditional high schools.
And they're all here for various reasons. There's not one type of student. It could have been because they were disruptive. It could have been that they were truant. It could be that they were behind in credits.
I used to like to be a class clown. I used to like the attention and all that. After my suspension, when I came back, they told me there's a new school called Career Academy. You'd be there.
At first, Gio wasn't happy with his new school, but that changed.
They give me the attention I needed, and I think that's what makes me like the school, because it gave me the attention that a regular school doesn't.
Caroline Rivera got lost in a sea of over 2,000 students at Liberty High School. She skipped school and just didn't care. At the Career Academy, she's one of 80 daytime students, and that has made all the difference.
There's too many things going on. There's too many people. I just couldn't concentrate, and that's mostly why I failed.
Caroline now has her sights set on college.
I'm planning on going to college. I want to go up for journalism. I like writing a lot.
The Bethlehem area school teachers who work here create customized curriculums for each class because each class may consist of different age groups and grade levels. It's definitely a non-traditional teaching experience.
I try to focus on the positive and focus on students who are doing the correct thing or meeting our expectations and try to heap praise on them.
As business instructor at the school, Gail Nolf works closely with the kids on their job skills.
One of the things that we try to do here is to get them to focus and channel their goals into a career choice.
I would like to go to college to go to school for business management. I like to own my own business.
Peter Sanchez overcame a few domestic hurdles, but he did it, and now with support from Career Academy, he's primed to pursue his talents.
I want to go to college and become a teacher. I actually teach dance at Northeast Middle School. I'm one of the coaches.
I've known Peter for 4 years. I love him as a son. He's never quit. He's extremely talented and creative and compassionate, and one day he will do great things.
The kids who once saw school as a dead-end road now see it as the way to fulfill their hopes and dreams.
We had 10 graduates last year. Two of them are in the military, and four, I believe, are going to start at NCC in January. So it's good to know that they started thinking about college, if not for the first time, with us.
It's good to know that kids who might have given up and dropped out of high school discovered a better way with a little help from some dedicated friends at Bethlehem's Career Academy. For Tempo in Depth, I'm Grover Silcox reporting.
We'd like to leave you tonight with some resources to do your own research. If you'd like to find out the dropout rate of any Pennsylvania high school, you can find it by going to pde.state.pa.us. Click on Statistical Reports, then click on Public Secondary School Dropouts. DoSomething.org is another great site to help you learn about the issue. It also offers suggestions you can do to make a difference. If everybody does something, together we can increase our high school graduation rates and help prepare our future workforce for the wonderful opportunities and challenges that wait ahead for them. Thanks so much for joining us. Good night.
Support for Tempo In-Depth is provided by the members of PBS 39 and by
building a workforce system called PA Career Link Lehigh Valley. Training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs. Connecting employers with workers and workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.